People, I got y'all right here on the 4-hourly. As y'all can see, the pattern is still valid, and I highly suggest y'all go watch my previous video so y'all know for a fact I know what I'm talking about, and y'all can read these charts because I had this drawing for I don't know how long now. But anyways, y'all can see it's playing out. Remove the drones, y'all can see. So boom, like I said, we got the M to the dub right here. Rise level one. You got the one test, two test, the third test, it breaks out. Like I told y'all it would. Now, what it's doing is about to bounce off this 200 EMA and engulf for level three, for the level three rise, as y'all can see right here. And the reason why I stopped right here, you look to the left, boom, right here, at 200 EMA, basically the same level. So it's stopping right before you get there and bouncing off to confirm the uptrend to the third level. Like I said, I believe third level, we should come up around $4,200. Because we've been a third level boom once we start, and we just got to wait for the peak formation, which is basically hitting this, like I say, this level right here around $4,200, anywhere around there. Hit y'all on the daily real fast. Y'all see the same thing. We're breaking past the 100 EMA. Same thing. But for a fact, we are not going past 4,300. Like, even if you was to go past 4,200, we cannot go past 4,300 because that'll be basically validating the uptrend, and it's not an uptrend. And the reason why you know it's not an uptrend is because this is a fake W formation for the people that don't know how to trade the correct way. But the right leg of the W always have to be higher than the left leg. This right leg is lower. So it's going to go even lower. If y'all don't pay attention, it's throwing out there for the ones that think y'all see what's happening, but it's not happening that way. For the longer term, that is. But let me show y'all the weekly. Now I'm going to show y'all the 12 months. See, on the weekly, though, you see the W much clearer. Some people might actually think that's a W and they're going to hop in thinking we got to go up to the uptrend. Now, like I said before, we already broke below, even lower. As y'all can see, it bounced off the 100 EMA, even previous videos, like where I had this pattern at. I told you I was going back down. It dropped below the 100 EMA. This is how they're going to trick you. That's why I was trying to explain to everybody. And all the markets are doing the same thing. They're trying to really reel everyone in, and they're going to smash down so fast. It's just going to be horrible. So anyway, once we pass this 100 EMA, again, I'm going to put give a specific number around, I'm going to say 3,600 to keep it simple. It's going to start flying. After 3,600, it could be one or two candlesticks taking it all the way down here to 2,500. That is our next support level. It's a 200 EMA. Zoom out even further. Hit y'all on the monthly chart. See, y'all can see even better. 200 EMA, right? Boom. Well, on the monthly chart, it's a 100 EMA. As y'all can see, it's clear as day that this is the next level down, our next support level. Y'all see one hit here, two hits here, and they both came and hit the 50 EMA. And now it's hitting the 50 EMA for the third time. Keep that in mind. Like I always tell y'all, market makers love doing things by threes. So it's going to definitely drop. And it's going to stop around here to fake everybody out again. We may even get a bounce up at that, a bounce up to around like 2,900, I'll say. And I say this because you see resistance, and these the close of these candlesticks right here, right? Specifically, definitely this doji, the hammer, however you want to call it. Because you can see these major support and resistance levels when they do this. That's what they do. They're testing the levels. So anyways, so we come down here for the third time, we're going to drop even lower. See right here, the red line. So right now, I'm just saying, the predicted low is 1,500. But honestly, I believe it's going way lower. But I'm just being generous right now. And we're going to wait and see, you know, and see what happens. Now, I pick 1,500 and go to the side. Excuse me, resistance. That's why I believe it'll be the next support before it drops again. But here's the bad news. Y'all probably don't want to hear. I'm gonna skip all the way to the 12-month chart. I know y'all probably not ready for it. I'm gonna do it anyways. Like I tell y'all, the pattern on the 12-month chart, a pattern started all the way back in 1930. Right here. 1930. W formation, rise level one. Rise level two, this is rise level three, and we are in peak formation, meaning it's not going to go higher than this anymore. Like I already explained to y'all plenty of times that they're about to drain all the stock markets and drop it into crypto because they're trying to turn everything digital. That's what they're doing. If y'all don't know, go watch my content, my IG or my TikTok, Universal P. I tell y'all the truth, what's really happening, but this is what's happening now. We're basically leveling out in our peak formation. Because right here, right before they started the peak formation right here, 2008, what happened? Bitcoin started. So they tried to run up the market and they're going to steal all the energy from everybody. The energy is actually the money. So they're going to smash these markets down. Like I told y'all, I don't believe the stock market is going to exist much longer after they turn everything digital. Because they're going to just, all they're going to do, like when you hear things about news this, news that, it got nothing to do with the news. They already have this plan. They use the news as an excuse to make the moves that they make. So y'all don't be suspicious or actually realize that everything is predetermined. Like I'm showing you right now, it's predetermined. I can read the chart. If you don't know how to read a chart, you will not know. You will sit here and think it's the news. The news is not the news. They already had this planned out. Once again, they started this pattern in 1930, 1929. The beginning is W. Level 1, level 2, level 3, peak formation. This is what's happening right now. That's on a 12-month chart, son. That means it's very possible they can just wipe out the whole market. Simple as that. And they have a reason to wipe out the whole market, which is turning everything digital. Just in case y'all didn't know. Now go right back here. See, rise level 1, level 2. We're going to see the same thing happen. Now watch this play out. Once it continue on up, right, after this retracement in the rise level 2, it's going to be in the rise level 3. It's going to go up on the level 3, right? It's going to drop. But then it's going to be peak formation, and then it's going to smash down. And like I said, that peak formation could be anywhere between $4,200 to $4,300. Because it's going to be a spike when this happens. It's going to be a real quick move, and it's going to be a quick move down. Because you see this candlestick right here? This is how they're going to reel everybody in. But I already told y'all it was coming. And they're moving it pretty fast now because they're trying to catch up to Bitcoin. Because Bitcoin is already in level 3 formation. And it's right there about to make its peak formation. So they cannot have Bitcoin crashing way before the stock market crashes. You feel me? So yeah. You know, quick rundown. Like I say, I believe we should get a peak up to $4,200 to $4,300. And then a reversal smashing straight down. And our next level we're looking at is around $2,500. And I could believe the low would be $1,500. Once again, being generous. Once you get around there, we'll see what it is. But anyways, anything I just said is not financial advice at all. Y'all grown, y'all make your own decisions. But like, comment, and subscribe. Peace.